Good morning to all the students of class 10B. Today we will be doing with a long composition. Fine. You might be knowing that in term 1 we have letters of complaint. So there are two categories which we will be doing. Firstly, we will be doing a letter of complaint in for business purpose. Here. And then what is the difference between when we write a letter for business purpose or official purpose? When we are having official letters, it means we are writing either to some government officials or any other related higher authorities. Clear? So these are called official letters. We are writing to some higher authority, like we are writing to some commissioner, head of municipal corporation, and all. Fine, they become official letters. So now, firstly, we will be doing business letter of complaint. So you can see I have drawn a line. On left side, you will be writing the format. And then we will be doing one example here. So let's start with this. First of all, sender's address. Yes, Silva. Have you started writing? Sender's address. And you need to skip a line. Beta, you will not be putting arrow here. You will just skip one line. And usually it is 2 to 3 line address. After skipping the line, okay, the format of the date is not like this, right? It will be like 29 July 2024. Then, after writing the date, again, you will skip one line. Receiver's address. Only 2-3 boys are talking to this class. This topic was receiver's address. Again, it will be a 3-line address in consecutive lines. Fine, you will not skip any line in between. You are writing to the manager, right? ABC Communication, Amritsar, in that way. So you won't be skipping line in between, that will be consecutive. Okay, so the keyword's address, fine. After writing that, you will write the subject. Again, skip my line. Then come to your subject. Underline the subject. Complaint about dash. Here. Complaint about dash. Yes. You sit down. If it comes, you don't suppose. Okay. Writer, how can you do? Anything is possible. If we are giving you grammar also in Google Forms, I already told you, this is just one plan of CBSE, that everybody sitting at home and sitting in the class, kindly go through the format of term 1 and term 2. Now your question is, how will we give writing skill? I will put one test, objective test of writing skills also, then you will see how it will come. Yeah? Suppose they can give one statement of the letter. Suppose to whom you are writing, they can give 4 options also. Either you're writing, whether it's a business letter, whether it's a personal letter or official letter or letter of inquiry or complaint or reply, or on salutation you get a question. On the content, two lines can be written there, asking for information or replying to the information or placing the order. Then they have asked what sort of letter it is. So you do not, you know, limit your thoughts to how writing skills can be affected. Anything can be there. But I told you that is the one plan of the CBSE. If same circumstances prevail, then it will be objective. Otherwise, if all the students will be called by the time, then again, another option we are having. So subjective and objective, you have to prepare for everything. Yeah? So let's continue. After this, writing the subject, you will not write complaining about. You will avoid writing ing plural. Yeah? Complained about dash. Whatever you are complaining about. Fine? So you can write here complaint about dash in the subject. Write down everyone. Complaint about dash. Then, salutation part with the, again, skip one line, or even if you do not skip line here, that is okay. You will be writing, dear sir. Yeah. And then from left side, you will start the content. It's not meant to preach the words. See here, where I have put arrow. Here, skipping line is mandatory. Here, I have not put any arrow. Where is your choice? So, content, it should be in three paragraphs here, and then the seat is with a wagon that will be calling the motor. Then at last, your students, after writing the content also, you just skip one line. Okay, that is the first. Your student and your name. Sometimes your designation is given. In that case, you will be writing designation. If it is not given, yes, children, you can see I have written designation here. It's not. Clear? Designation. This is the format of all the business letters. Basically, you have done earlier also. Before exams, before holidays, we have also done letter of inquiry, right? So, format is the same. But you will be noting down this format in the notes also. Because they have not mentioned any other letter. In term one, they have mentioned letter of complaints only. Fine? So, this is the format. Any doubt, you can ask me. Let's continue with one statement. So write down one statement, Vita. Statement is, you are Nikhil or Nisha. Everybody write down the statement, then we will do one example. You are Nikhil or Nisha. Staying at 53, staying at 53 Modern Hills, Hyderabad. Last month, you bought last month you bought a television from the Clear Vision. From the Clear Vision. This is the name of that shop, right? Or firm from where you have made that purchase. The Clear Vision with warranty of 2 years. After the format, you have to write a statement as well in the service, right? With the warranty of 2 years. Now you discover that the picture gets blurred. The picture gets blurred. B-L-U-R-R-E-D. Now you discover that the picture gets blurred. B-L-U-R-R-E-D. Every now and then. Every now and then. Every now and then means many a times in a day whenever you switch on the TV. So there is a blur vision. You are not able to see the clear picture. Every now and then, full stop. Even the sound has become defective. Even the sound has become defective. You see, they have given you hints in the statement itself. Find two problems and you are going to make a letter of complaint. So complaints, they have already mentioned two. You can add up more into it. Yes, voice. If any problem, ask me, don't ask your friends. So, write down. Write a letter to the dealer. Write a letter to the dealer complaining about the problem and requesting him to either rectify the problem, rectify the problem or replace the television. Two options are going to give to the video. Or replace it. Yes, Beta. So, warranty period. You might have seen whenever you purchase anything, warranty of 1 year, 2 years. So, warranty means if the things are not working as per your expectations, you can ask for replacement also. Here, that is the warranty period. So terms and conditions, they vary from company to company. Yeah. So you should be aware while purchasing, you should see what is the guarantee period and what is the warranty period. Sometimes they just give guarantee of that this thing will be perfectly working for 2 years. And after that, you do not give any guarantee. Then you cannot claim it. So we have to read the terminology accordingly. So now write down, beta, everything is given in the statement. So your address, now tell me, who will tell me, yes? And this address I will write. 53 Modern Hills. So write down, everyone. Sender's address. Thank you. kind of business is the futures. And I have written wrong. So I find some children of this class just waste their time because they are free and they think that rest of the children are doing projects. Rather than concentrate on what's going on in the class. So after writing center's address, which is 53 Modern Hills, Hyderabad, skip one line. Now the format of the date is this 29th July. In that way you will be writing, not in numeric format. Okay? When you are done, I will be checking those you are finished. Then skip one line again. Yes, next. Yeah. Tell me the receiver's address with us. What is written in the statement? You are going to write to the dealer also. So you can write the dealer also, you can write the manager also, both will be acceptable. Yeah? The dealer or the manager. The dealer is the one who deals in. Sometimes they have kept the manager also. Whatever is mentioned in the statement, you have to write accordingly, the designation. And very important point, if no designation is mentioned here in the statement, then you have to invent it. But one recipient should be there. Here, after this, what is the address? Clear Vision. The Clear Vision, Hyderabad. This is the name of the company or shop. Yes. Then after this, you will be writing the subject after skipping one line. This should be bifurcated, different. That's why we are skipping one line. Yeah? Now in the subject, what will be writing? Complaint about defective television. Complaint about defective television. Yes, this boy, get up. Come here. Find defective television. Defective TV also you can write. Here. Complaint about defective TV. Now, salutation. Yes, sir. You can skip a line. Now you will be writing the content. Let me discuss what to write. Then you will be writing on your own. I won't be dictating you, obviously. So, there will be three paragraphs, Vita. My voice is audible to all of you. Those who are sitting at home, kindly send me thumbs up. I'm checking those who are there. Tanya, Visam, Mehek, Navya, Par, Prabjot, Sayam, Lakshita. Fine. Yes, Pita. In the first paragraph, firstly, you will introduce yourself. Write down the value points where you have written the format or on another page. Here, don't write here. Here, you will be continuing your letter. So value points, what to write, I would be now creating this format you have already done. What to write in the content now? Yes, in first paragraph, value points for that. First of all, you have to tell who you are, introduce yourself. That is the very first point. Clear? Your name is given in the statement. I am Nikhila. 53 Modern Hills, Hyderabad. So this is your recognition because they have not given any designation to you that you are representing because of company. Sometimes it is written you are the manager of some company, some school, some organization. So in this, they have not given any designation. So your address and your name is the recognition. I am Nikhila, 53 Modern Hills, Hyderabad. After writing this, you will tell the purpose of writing the first paragraph only. Purpose of writing. This is the complaint letter. Obviously, firstly, you will be mentioning that I purchased dash. You have to be very, very formal, beta. Don't use very casual language here. You have to be very, very formal. Yeah, that I purchased an LG television. You can tell inches also, right? Centimeters also. In that way, you can tell the measurement. And after that, tell the date also. The date you purchased that TV. Yeah, I purchased an LG television from your company on last month. Then you can give on 5th June 2021. Yeah. So purpose of writing and facts also you have to mention. These are the facts on day and date when you purchase that thing. Clear? And it was purchased with a 2 years warranty. You have to tell that. That was the terminology given by you. This was purchased with 2 years warranty. Yeah. So I'm writing this letter to bring to your kind notice about various defects this television started showing within a span of 1 month. This is the matter or content for the first paragraph. You will not tell the defects in first paragraph. Yeah. Introduce yourself. Tell the facts. When the thing was purchased, tell that warranty period. Yeah. And then you have to tell the defects in second paragraph. Now, yes, second paragraph will be carrying the content of. Now, make complaints here. In second paragraph, you will be making complaint or complaints. Sometimes it is related to such issue, there is one complaint only. Sometimes there are multiple complaints. Right? Complaint or complaint accordingly. So in second paragraph, you will be telling that the television which I have bought from you does not give satisfactory working. Why you tell that the working is not satisfactory? This is a crux of the whole complaint. Now, start telling part by part. That's two complaints they have already mentioned in the statement. The sound system is not proper, it's not audible, sometimes it's too loud, sometimes it becomes too low automatically. So there is a problem in the system. The vision is quite blurred. Sometimes it starts working properly, and every now and then it starts showing blurred pictures. Fine. Then you can tell that I have paid more than 40,000 rupees for this branded television, but it is not up to our expectations. Here, one more defect you can add up. Try to add up one more defect because two are already given in the statement. What is your input here? You have to add up one or more defects. Clear? So, after that, you can tell that we have sent reminders. Now, in third paragraph, after making complaints, you can tell that we have sent reminders to your company via email and letters. but no response was given to us. Fine. In third paragraph, you will conclude. But how you will conclude? Ask them to replace. Either replace or repair. पहले repair का Ask to repair. If not possible, then because warranty period is there, you will mention that. We send three reminders to you to send your service engineer to remove the defects. It seems that I am left with no alternative but to ask you to replace it only. Clear? I hope my complaint would be, yes, Vita, what is the problem? At last, you would be hoping that they would be seeing to this matter and taking it on priority basis. The Deepa, they have already not responded to you. Yeah? So I hope that my grievance, sometimes you can write my complaint, would be considered immediately and immediate action would be taken. This should be your language. You can note down. But at last, you will hope that they would be repairing either or replacing. I hope my complaint would be accepted and an immediate action would be taken in this regard. At last, before writing, Vida, you all Surya Pekarti, hoping for an early response, hoping for a timely response. Yours truly and your name. Clear? Any doubt? The ones who are talking now, they will be coming here to tell me the next content of the next letter. Clear? Girls, any doubt to you? This side, center line, this row. Yes, children sitting at home, if any doubt, type in the chat box, I will reply. We have done letter of complaint for business purpose only. Tomorrow we will do letter of complaint for official purpose. Here, with this, only two writing skills are mentioned for term one, that will be over. And then we'll pick up grammar, fine, accordingly. No doubt is there?